everything, come on down.
I'm really excited about this album because I'm really, really happy with all the songs on it. It feels like mine, and it feels like ours. It feels like, you know, the band that have been involved in it.
I found a great big hole in the middle of my life, shaped just like my heart.
It just seems like a really organic kind of a thing. It's a proper statement, and I'm not unhappy with any aspect of it. So I'm happy to let that go out into the world and see what people make of it. I come from a wee village called Banknoke, which is in Stirlingshire, right in the middle of Scotland's central belt. And I grew up at the top of a hill in a cottage. I had an amazing primary school, really fantastic teachers at school, and they set up this little group called the Banknoke Kids. And it was proper gigs with microphones, sound checks, you know, harmony, backing singers and all the rest, drum kit. And I was about 9 or 10 when I joined this band. It was really exciting. And we used to play in old folks' homes and the local psychiatric hospital. But it was really dead exciting because it was proper gigs and lots of perks as well, because it was really fantastic cakes that all the old ladies cooked.
I keep linking the daisies into chains.
My mum says I've been writing songs ever since I could talk, practically. My gran died a few years ago, and there was a lot of tapes lying about in her house after she died, and some of them were ones of me making songs up with my next door neighbour when I was about 8 or 9, and they were all country songs because my granny was a country music fan, all about losing your, you know, broken hearted and, you know, just dying for the loss of love and all the rest of it. So I think I've kind of always been doing it, and looking back on it, it's been like a thread through my whole life. The first time I ever sang one of my own songs in public, I think I was 12, and it was a song I'd written about Northern Ireland. And I suppose for me growing up, you know, I was coming into high school in the 80s, and it was really the big news story then. And for me, it seemed awful close. I mean, Ireland is awful close. Like there was a war going on in my doorstep. So I was writing about Northern Ireland because it was the thing that really mattered to me. And that's the first time I can remember, I think, singing a song that I'd written in public. And it wasn't really until quite a lot later that I started doing it again, because I got awful shy after that. So in a sense, I'm a folk singer because I suppose folk songs and folk singers sing about things, and I sing and I write about things. I'm not fundamentally interested in writing introspective, whinging songs, the kind of songs that people assume singer-songwriters write. I don't really write those kind of songs. I mean, good luck to the people who do, but I'm much more interested in observing the world and other people in it and my place in it. And that's a thing that's common to folk singers. So in that sense, I'm a folk singer. But I think a lot of the musical influences are from indie music and from Americana music. So there's lots of stuff going on there.
At least he heard, no doubt. At least he heard.
The BBC Two Folk Awards was a massive turning point in my career, and I can't overstate what a difference it made to me personally. I released my album, my first album, Fault Lines, a year before the Folk Awards kicked off, and it was a struggle, quite frankly. It was quite hard to kind of get gigs and hard to find an audience, and getting played on Radio 2 and getting press and just getting an overwhelming amount of support from people I had no idea were even aware I existed was just a massive boost in confidence. It's an album that's taken its time a bit more, I think, than Fault Lines has. When I recorded Fault Lines, I got together a bunch of musicians, most of whom are my friends and family, to record an album. And I had never really played with those musicians. And we got together in the studio to record the album. And I'm really proud of the album that we made. But the difference with Scribble and Chalk is that I've recorded an album with musicians that I've actually been playing with live. And to me, it sounds like that. It sounds like there's a core of five of us at the heart of the album who've been playing for over a year now and making the stuff sound great just within that small number of people, and all the stuff that's been added on top of it. And there's some really beautiful things, a string quartet, lovely little harp and Wurlitzer flourishes, my little sister on Glockenspiel, all kinds of little bits and pieces. They're kind of, they're dressing now rather than fundamental. The stuff stands up on its own with this core group of five musicians. I've been trying to talk over the sound of Russian blood. Scribbled in Chalk is a little tiny bit of a line from the opening track of the album Hole in the Heart, and the whole line is, truth is a story scribbled in chalk just an hour before the flood. And I suppose I picked that little bit of line for the title because to me that's the thread that runs through the whole album, is this idea of uncertainty. Things come and things go. I say in another song, clouds form and disperse. There's recurring kind of idea of the world keeps on moving, and I suppose it keeps on moving both for better and for worse.